these guys, this is my older group. These guys range in age from 8 to 11, excuse me. And they have been working on this show very hard for the past 2 weeks. So, oh, and before I welcome them to the stage, I'm pretty sure we ran out of programs. So if you would like one and you did not get one, just give Perrin, our house manager, your address, and he will mail you one, because I know they can be nice souvenirs for family. All right, and now, without further ado, please welcome the cast of Could You Hug a Cactus?
Bye. deal. Well, I guess it's kind of a big deal. I'm the speediest kid in the whole neighborhood. I pedal way faster than anyone could. I got double A power right under my hood. I'm Rodney. Deafening skills, just check out my beautiful 7-inch reels. As I head on home for our family meals, I'm Rodney. I'm Rodney. I got the fastest tricycle in town. I'm Rodney. Tall warm glass of milk will put me down.
Dangerous, and so are socks and tiles. And bumpy paths can lead to knees that bump in the same spots. And darkened rooms can lead to heads all covered up in knots. It's good to be a clumsy kid once in a blue moon. I'm waiting for that time to come. I hope it gets you soon.
Hey everyone, we hope you like our poem so far. We've spent lots of time picking every word to live on the right. We want to be just right, because when a poem is just right, it should involve our feeling and what we're thinking. Sort of like a magic trick, don't you think? Magicians love their magic words, like abracadabra, alakazam, presto, change-o, simsalabim, hocus pocus, and balabalam. Like smatter, slatter, smatter, stop. Or look over there, or come plore. Magicians love their magic words, but poets love them even more.
You hear that? Late at night, I hear noises, creaks, and groans, and clunks from inside my bedroom walls. Once, I swear, I heard someone giggle. My mom says, it's just a pie, come back to sleep. But I know the truth. There lives a man inside my wall. He does not have much room at all. He has no bath, he has no sink. He does not have the space to think. He has no couch, he has no chairs, or place to put the clothes he wears. He loves to live his life that way, except when family comes to stay.
Mucus-covered glare,
a platinum blue, a garshot snap, a powdered bag of fat, there's Tommy with me in it.
Well, record-breaking speed. These folks will quickly write themselves. Now let's keep the creativity flame with our next poet. She may not have been ready before, but this is her time to shine.
Hi, I'm not really sure what to say here. All right, I can try. Okay. Roses are red, violets. No, it has to be deeper. How's this? I sometimes feel like I'm a kite way up in the sky, and then I fly and fly. I'm not doing good, everyone. I hate this. I'm terrible at wasting everyone's time. I shouldn't even be here. You write something I can't.
Hey, it's okay. This is hard. It takes time. We all get stuck. But you don't even need to write something perfect. Write something good. Remember.
Start with the sentence and end with the rhyme. See how far it goes. So take a deep breath and take your time as it flows. It flows, it flows.
Saving trees, or keeping bees, or chasing my desires. Sometimes it seems improbable that I could ever be a person who is worth somebody looking up to me. Sometimes it seems impossible that I could ever do anything great at all until I talk to you. Wow, that felt great. Actually, it felt amazing. Thank you, everyone.
Well, I guess that's it. It's the last poem. I hope you liked our show. Don't worry. Just because it's over doesn't mean we're going to start making things. We're just getting started.
Build the things you want to see. Make your thoughts come true. Roll your sleeves and get to work. Things you make for your own sake will build you up inside.
Oh my God.